Welcome back to another video. Thanks for joining me today. Today's video is going to be the giveaway tumbler. Please enjoy. All right, so to get this one started, we are going to trim off all of this excess white. Actually, what I need is 8 inches. Save that piece and cut this edge off. And we'll get this edge. Okay. But I've been watching Trina from Diamonds and Dust. Excuse me. And she has this hack, at least I've watched her do this hack. If you're gonna have a pattern in your vinyl, which I am going to, I'm gonna have some waves in it. So she takes this contact paper, removable. You're going to simply put it on top of this. So I'm gonna cut here. Here. Okay, and we're going to take this and apply it on top of the vinyl. Okay, so as you can see, I did get off a little bit, but that's all right. Not to worry. Okay.
All right, so once that contact paper is on there, you're going to put it through your cutting machine to cut the design out. It's going to cut out both the contact paper and the vinyl. So here I am just putting the vinyl onto the tumbler. I'm using a True 22. I believe this is a sublimation tumbler that I sanded down prior to this step. I'm going to wrap it around and make sure that it lines up as good as I can get it. And then use my squeegee and just go right along and smooth it on. And here the design right there, you could see it lifted a little bit. Well, it didn't lift a bit. I had to fiddle with it to get it onto the cup correctly. Pardon. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this up. And not bad. It lined up rather well. Okay, and then I went ahead and trimmed the top and the bottom off. And we are going to start with peeling off the first section to be painted and glittered. And my cutting machine, I didn't quite have it right. So some of these spots stuck a little bit. So I had to just take my craft knife and cut it a little bit to separate the cut. I forget which settings I used, but I will try to go back at my silhouette and look. Or I'll go back and see the screenshot that I took of her answer when I asked her what settings she used. This is an absolute awesome method. I just really love it. It helps keep your lines straight. So I'm gonna go in with pink, pink petal from Colorflex. It is a 2-in-1. glue is mixed in. We're going to use the Wildflower for PDB Creative Studio. And yeah, I went a little overzealous on my paint here. However, it doesn't really matter because whatever I get on my vinyl, you're not going to be able to see it because of that contact paper. So go ahead and spread this out, make it nice and even, get some nice good full coverage. Just slop it on if you really wanted to, but try to keep it as contained as possible. I love the color of this paint. It really does match really well with this tumbler, the vinyl. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and pour on the glitter. Look at how gorgeous that wildflower glitter is. I love this glitter. I think it was in the glitter pack 62 or something like that. I forget. But I will have everything that I use linked and listed and linked below in my description box, along with a couple of coupon codes for ya. Get all that pink covered. And apparently I cut out the second pink section because we're gonna move straight into the yellow section, which you'll see here in a sec. Go ahead and pull away this piece. And look at how clean that is. Look, oh, it's amazing. So satisfying. Okay, I'm gonna clean it off a little bit because I got some extras hanging about. And clean this little top section off because I got a little too much pink right there. So thank you for stopping by, like I said, to watch my video. Thank you for subscribing. If you are not a current subscriber, please consider subscribing so you don't miss any content. I am release videos on Saturdays, and I've decided that I'm going to try to get some videos out here and there. This is the French Silk by Colorflex and the Honeysuckle by PDB Creative Studio. Because I do have other videos, and I, you know, if I just do once a week, I'm, you know, anyway, I'm going to try to get more videos out. So this paint, some of these you have to shake a lot. And as you can see right there, I didn't shake this one well enough. So it ran into my pink, and yeah, I was not real thrilled with this. I fixed it. I mean, I did fix it as well as I could. I'm going to go ahead and just spread the rest of this out, take some paper towel, and so yeah, I'm going to take some paper towel and blot out as much as that I can, and just continue on and go with it for the time being. So look at this honeysuckle. This honeysuckle is beautiful. I do realize now that as I've been editing this video, that I probably should have went with a lighter colored base paint. But in the grand scheme of things, when this tumbler is finished, I don't think you really notice it. And I think it turned out gorgeous. I love how this tumbler turned out. So there we go. We're going to take some... Oh, this is where the satisfaction comes in from the contact paper. So you very carefully will need to peel that contact paper off. Very carefully. Excuse me. And watch this. Come on, girl, get it. Maybe I should have sped through this part a little bit. There we go. Oh, look at that. Look at how clean that line is. See all the excess pink paint on there where I was a little sloppier? But as far as the line, the glitter line is concerned, you can't. There's no paint. It's amazing. It's beautiful. All right, so here, this is where I'm going to try to take this glitter glue and cover up that dark spot. and I think I did pretty good with this. I do say so myself. All right, just going to go ahead and pat down that glitter glue, dump on a little more of the wildflower. And I think I'd pat it down with my finger a little bit. Maybe, maybe not. I'm gonna take some wax paper, roll the tumbler up in it to flatten out the glitter. And then we will move on.
Sorry about the crappy view, but she is drying in the tumbler curing machine. 2 hours, she should be ready to go.
All right, and so once that layer of epoxy has cured, it is time for a little bit of cleanup. Look how beautiful and shiny. So beautiful. I did use Flynn Sisters premium resin on this. And there we're going to use some 80 grit sandpaper and get that top. Nice fine line around the rim of this for future layers of epoxy to adhere to. Okay, and I'm going to sand up the bottom. Just give this a nice sanding anywhere that it needs it, because for the most part it was pretty smooth. But that chunky glitter is, you know, you gotta put a little sanding in. Clean it up with some isopropyl alcohol, and then we will move on to the striping. I'm gonna use this nail striping tape to stripe out all of the lines on this tumbler. And I just lined it up here and just kind of very slowly and carefully went around these curves, because, you know, it's not really bendable tape, but if you go slow enough, you can get one like consistent line there, which is pretty cool, I thought. So just go ahead and continue to stripe this out. This thing is coming to life. Bottom, get this piece. And I think that's just about it right there. It took a little bit longer to get curved around. Clean up the corners. And then we're gonna move on to using some quick coat from CC DIY. But look how pretty. I love it, love it, love it. So I'm gonna use this quick coat, cover all that striping up, put another layer of epoxy on, and we are ready for the decals. My tumbling machine, this was in the tumbling machine, dry-in machine. I don't know if you can see on the bottom there, but I got a little bit of a bubble butt, bottom, muffin bottom. Anyway, so, pardon me. I'm gonna use my little light pad here to layer Jennifer's name. And I used some pink, some pastel pink vinyl from Cricut. And then the gold, I don't remember where I got my gold from, but I will, like I said earlier, I will have it all linked and listed below. Once I have that lined up, I'm going to use that straight line right there to that's where I'm going to put Jennifer's name, and a measure here to make sure that I got as evenly centered in that vinyl section as possible. Lift it up, snip off some of that. Just make sure that I'm using the line on the transfer tape as well to make sure that this is lined up perfect. Remove the rest of that, and voila, there we go. I think the gold I may have gotten from HTV Ront. Fix the bottom of the F there, because that was very thin, and it was just very thin, so it was needed a little adjusting. So we're gonna cut around the decal. Be sweet, be kind, be humble. Love this decal. Gonna line it up. Before I remove the back, I'm going to measure this. I wanted to make sure that this tumbler was as perfect as I could get it. So I'm trying to do all of the proper things. And so now I'm pretty sure I got a good spot. I'm gonna cut this off. And before, just before, I wanna make sure again that I've got it even. I'm gonna apply that. And then take my little squeegee and just swish over, and voila, there we go. And then for some reason this was bunched up or something, I don't recall, but I obviously had to cut it out, so there we go. And then we are ready to start applying those cute little honeycombs over there. So I decided to use the pattern, the vinyl, to make some extra honeycomb to kind of cover up. It wasn't initially to cover up any boo-boos, but it does help to cover up those boo-boos. All right, and then I'm going to go along and just apply these everywhere where I think they need to be or look good. Come on, girl, get it off there. Get with the program. And as I was saying earlier about the muffin bottom, I'm not quite sure right why I still applied this vinyl here. Maybe it wasn't bubbled right there. I don't know, muffined. But anywho, so I'm going to go ahead and just go around and apply these honeycombs. And if you are enjoying this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And if you're not currently subscribed, please consider to subscribe. All right, I'm going to put my logo on the bottom here. Not quite centered, so I'm going to peel her back off. You can tell right there. Looking at it right, that angle, it was not centered correctly. I'm just gonna tilt it down and kind of try to get it as lined up as possible and centered in the center of the tumbler. All right, and then we're gonna go and this is where I decided, I think, that I need to remove these because I need to fix this bottom. I can't have a muffin bottom on this tumbler. I was so disheartened. I was so upset when I saw that, too. I'm like, oh, why? So I go ahead and anyway, sand this down, get it as level with the rest of the tumbler as possible. And then I'm going to go ahead and continue to finish up the rest of these honeycombs, and then I believe we'll be ready for some epoxy after that. So cute. I guess I could have probably left some of these honeycombs out, but I did want you to get, Jennifer, the true making, really. I mean, I guess not true, because this is sped through quite a bit. Next, we're getting ready for the next step. Okay, so after the last coat of epoxy I put on, it needs to be cleaned up, but it's so cute. Love how it's turning out. I'm going to do a little bit of sanding because my vinyl right there is sticking up a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and sand that. I'm going to use a 400 grit, going real light with it, because I don't want to sand it down too much. Just enough so it's not sticking up. clean the rim off of it too. You do want to do this before. As I was saying, you want to clean off the rim of your cup after each layer of epoxy. You don't want all that build up and try to get it all off at once. It'll be a pain in the tuchus. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and continue to clean off the rim. Give it a quick sanding, sand down the rest of this a little bit, clean it off with a little bit of isopropyl alcohol, and move on to the next step, which will be the drip. And I don't believe that I epoxied in between this and the drip, so I think I waited until after the drip. So there we go, just clean it off and move on. So what I have here is just under 2 ounces of epoxy. I used Flynn's Sister's Artist Cure, parts A and B. I am going to put in some of this Jackpot from Glitter Fetish. It's a beautiful micro powder that I got as a freebie in one of my subscription boxes from Butterfly Lane Designs. Okay, and I'm just gonna go ahead and put in some and mix it up until I get the color I want. Going to make a honey drip on this cup. Probably have far too much epoxy in here, but I don't really know. I've never done an epoxy drip before either, so hopefully this turns out. Because I'd really hate to put it on a cup and have it not turn out. However, I can, before it dries, wipe it off to the best of my ability if I don't like it. That's a beautiful color. Golden honey drip. Try to get all incorporated. I'm stuck on my stick here. Okay. That's going to be a gorgeous color next to this cup. I do believe. Okay, so I think it's enough. Get a gorgeous drip out of that. So we are going to let this sit for 20 minutes. And be back. Okay, so this has been sitting for a little more than 20 minutes. Clearly not thick enough. It's still way runny. So I'm going to use this nice and thick. It's a thickening agent from CCDI or Counterculture DIY. I've never used this either, so hopefully it works well. And I can do this right and not ruin my epoxy. You do need quite a bit of this, so I'm gonna put a few scoops in, probably 5. We'll mix that up. a timing thing. You don't want your epoxy to be too thin, but you also don't want it to be too thick that it doesn't run or that it flash cures on you. That's what I do not want. So get this all mixed in. See, it's still way too runny. Okay, so I'm gonna let this sit for another 20 minutes. And we'll come back and test it out. Probably add some more of the nice and thick. Make sure it's all incorporated. Yep. Okay, well, we'll be back in 20 minutes. All right, so it has been another 20 minutes. Let's test this out. Getting mighty warm. Still pretty runny, so let's put some more nice and thick in it. Stuff's kind of flaky. Not flaky, but powdery. It all incorporated. I watched Mallory from Made by Manny and Mel before I did this, and she used much more of the nice and thick than I have. So I don't know if I need to add more to this, or because it is getting warm. I don't know how warm hers got. She didn't really mention that, at least. If she did, I missed it. But that is still pretty runny, so let's go ahead and add some more. It's really a timing, like I said earlier. Well, that's what she says too. It's really a fine line of the timing and the nice and thick. You don't want too much, but you don't want your epoxy to start curing before you even get it on your cup either. So maybe that'll do it. She said kind of like peanut butter. And she was using KS resin also, so that could make a difference. I mean, I'm sure it does make a difference, the type of resin that you use. Brand, obviously type, you don't necessarily need to do this with the fast set resin. And since I've never done it before, I don't want to take that chance just yet. That's looking pretty good though, I think. Please feel free to leave in the comments if I am got a better suggestion for me or something. Maybe the way that you do it, if you do it. It's still pretty thin. Runny, I mean, not thin. Running pretty good. So I don't want to have to babysit the cup either and flip it upside down and back and forth. So I think I'll go ahead and leave it for another maybe 10 minutes. I don't want to overwork it either. Yeah. 10 more minutes, I'm gonna leave it. 5 more minutes. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and put it on because it is pretty thick. If I have to babysit it, then I do. It's just the way it is. I don't want any of those little hangy, wispy things, and that's probably far too much on there. But I'm going to put little bits along the top. Maybe I'll go this way since I'm left-handed.
So I'm going to go ahead and speed through this because for one, I'm out of frame, and for two, I didn't do this correctly at all and I kind of struggled with it. Instead of going along it, this rim like that, I should have been going up and down, I guess, like scraping my stick along the top of it. I do manage to get a pretty decent drip out of this, but it did take some finagling and some
some little effort in. Okay, this stuff is pretty dang thick. I'm going to hit it up with my heat gun for a second. Some of those spots are kind of thick. But I think that looks pretty cool. Well, it's kind of thick. for a first drip, I guess it's not bad, huh?
All right, so a little more heat gun. Just try to loosen it up because, as I said, it was pretty thick on the tumbler. And then I'm going to just work it and try to get the best results.
Okay, so that's more like it. I'm gonna hold it up this way a little bit. Start going into the B. I don't want it to cover up her name. Okay, we'll go ahead and put this on the spinner now. Let that even out some more. And we'll move on to the next step. Once this is cured, I'm going to sand down the top rim there and fix that. And then I'll go over it with probably just one more coat, because I don't want this coat or this cup to be too heavy. It's a lot on the epoxy on there. So, but I think she looks super cute. I hope Jennifer loves her.
All right, so as you can see there, I did end up sanding down the rim, and I'm going to go ahead with the Flynn Sister Supply Shop Premium Epoxy. I believe I used probably 25 ounces, maybe 20, and just did this part wrong too. I should have went with the drip first and then moved along the bottom, down to the bottom, but I guess I just like to do things backwards around here. But get a nice thin coat of epoxy on this, making sure to get every little bit. You want to get in your finger or some sort of tool or something in between those little honey drips to make sure that it doesn't pull up. So if you find any pulling, you want to like push it down so it doesn't pull around those drip marks. And look how that
mica, that golden mica, came to life again. I love it. Anyway, so I'm going to let this dry, and this little beauty is ready to be shipped off to her new owner. So I want to say thank you so much to everybody for participating in my giveaway. Thank you for supporting my channel. It means the world to me, and I greatly appreciate each and every one of you. And here is this beautiful tumbler. Jennifer, I hope you love it. Thank you for your support. And again, everybody, thank you for your support. And if you are not a current subscriber, please consider subscribing so you don't miss out when I make little beauties like this one. So that is going to conclude this video. Have a good day, have a good night, whatever it may be for you, and I will see you in my next video.